lollipop time.
Hello, everybody. I'd like to update you on the PS2 online thing. Now, I feel like my first video wasn't very good, because many of you kept asking questions. So, I'd just like to update everyone. Also, settings changed, so I wanted to show you everything new. So, you had this previous setup. It could still work, it probably doesn't anymore, I don't know. So I just like to show you, get this thing off. PS2. Ethernet cable, one of these things, connected straight to your router. Just gotta skip the intro. Hopefully this video would, I guess, get some people to bring out their old PS2 or maybe just decide to do something with their PS2 if it's already out or whatever. And basically get the online backup again. This is the network login screen. Note, every online game pretty much has to be powered by GameSpy in order for this to work. But it's one thing, one special thing. Just go to create your network configuration. Now, I don't know if you noticed, but on the screen, it said New Open Spy, which was what I thought this was originally called. I don't know if it's still OpenSpy or anything like that. I don't even know if this is OpenSpy anymore. But what I do know is that these games basically run off DNS servers. Or DNAS servers. So I guess I'll show you a preview setting. So my record slot 1. New OpenSpy created just today. Select Ethernet cable, not required. Unless it is required, then go on, put your username, password, and console information. No, I don't think it's PS2 console, I think it's the router. IPS address, auto. Now here is the thing, DNS servers. These, you just enter, they're basically like entering codes to go to different servers in different places. So secondary DNS actually doesn't even need anything. Like in the first video I said, oh, blah, 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 I entered this into this. There's different codes you can search online. I'll show you an example website later. This code I have inside, I found 4 of them. This one works, I know for a fact, because I've used it to play online. Set the connection test, it should be successful. If not, then you should probably change up things. But from what I know, it works as long as it's plugged in. There you go. Name new OpenSpy. Here's your information. Saving. Make sure it saves. There you go. And go back to the game. So once again, we're back at the network login screen. Select your new thing. Doesn't have to be named New OpenSpy. It's just what I selected or chose to call it. Click connect. Takes a little bit. Then this screen shows up the DNAS authentication. So you see, it recognizes it as a real server and it works. It's my name, my stupid name that I don't know why I put. Obviously no one's online because no one knows about this yet. Or at least not very many people at the same time. So for example, I'll just create a session. Here we go. And our game starts to load. This is gonna take a little while. Not too long, but also don't get impatient. Here we go. None of these are like SMGs. guess this is something. Obviously, there's no player, so we'll just skip. And you're in an online match. Once again, this one you can better see instead of, like, I don't remember what map I chose. Ignore my pro skills, because honestly, this is very difficult to play. I'm so used to... doesn't have any grenades, does he? I'm so used to PlayStation 3 or 4 controls. Even then, I thought this would be like PS3 controls, but there's no run. I'm clicking down L3. L4 does... or L3... or R3 does nothing. That does whatever. It's been like a minute and it ends. And as you can see, this does in fact work. I'm not, like, there's no strings attached, nothing. Super easy, basic. Like I said, I'll show you the website that has these things. It's like a forum, actually. So I'll just list these. You have to search on the internet for it. So-and-so game, like, I don't know, Topspin DNAS. I can't get this to run because it requires, like, 2 megabits and... I have none of that space. Let's switch to something that's gonna be a machine gun. This is not a machine gun, it's just like... No. Okay, that's a machine gun. Never mind. This button, instead of pressing R3, it's actually like punch or stab button. And the other one... L3 or L2, it's grenade. And the top buttons are like PS3. Circle is crouch, triangle is actually jump, X is pick up items, and square, like always, is reload. And I'm guessing, I don't know if there's kill streaks, but you can click the D-pad. And yeah, basically the first Call of Duty online, PS2. I was attempting to get my Xbox original, I have a Crystal Edition, tried to get it online. Couldn't play Project Gotham Racing. It sure does the local thing, but like, I don't know what to play with. Oh, this is the level I chose last time. No one could see. Well, I guess it's visible now. Yeah. I'll see you guys all later. I'm lonely.
If you still don't quite get it, here. Here's
an example. With World Championship Poker, you can only use one code per game. So it's a little irritating, but honestly, it's better than nothing.
So right here is the PS2 online gaming website, which is the forum I was talking about earlier. Here is where I found the DNSs. As you can see, Call of Duty 1, Finest Hour, which is the game I just demonstrated. This is the DNS I used of all of the millions. I'll just go through them. You can pause it whenever you wish to, I guess, enter that code or whatever you want to do. Some require secondary. Let's see if I can find one. Right here, Metal Gear Solid. Some require secondary and primary ones. Also, I don't know if you saw, but if you scroll a bit lower, the list kind of ends and it goes into bypass code, which I honestly don't know how to do and don't care for it because DNS is much easier. I guess there's probably a couple games that may use it better. As you can see, with cheat devices and or patch engines, so like I don't have any of those. I'll scroll through the bypass codes if you feel like doing those, but I don't know. One thing to note, though, is that most PS2s, I don't know, because some people have slim, some people have fats, and I don't have fats, so I don't know, but as long as your thing has, like, a network cable or a line in for, like, dial-up, I don't know who uses dial-up, but, like, you can buy network adapters for fat, so I'm assuming they don't have it. Other systems such as the Dreamcast come built in, with Line and stuff like that. And they have adapters. Let's see if I can get this thing off. Yeah, see? Line. You can insert LAN adapter, but honestly that thing's way too expensive, along with the GameCube one. No one has that either. But it's possible to get the GameCube online. Xbox has one too. They have a, not Line, I think they have a network adapter. But yeah. Basically, if your system has that, you can connect it to the internet, but I honestly doubt it, because the older ones still have that, don't really work. The newer ones, like 360 and PS3, they still work. So yeah.
So you're gonna need a code for World Championship Poker. It's different from the Call of Duty one. Actually, I don't even know if they have one. You're gonna have to search on the internet. They have ones for the other Call of Duties, and like I said, the examples I just showed you. Select multiplayer online. The default character that I don't use because I don't play this game. I don't know why I have it. Oh yeah, because I got this PS2 like pre-owned a while back. And it came with like a million games that no one plays. Most of them are sports. So I have to get my own collection. If you can't tell, I like Guitar Hero. Thing that's probably not going to use an adapter for the controller. Guitar one, red octane. Same as the other one, just scroll on down and accept, because you don't need to read any of that anymore. Select. Not OpenSpy, but new OpenSpy. Connecting. Once again, this is another GameSpy game. Right there. Oh, hold on, focus. There you go. Look. This is also a GameSpy game that requires 2 megabytes, like I said earlier. So now, you know how to get your PS2 online once again. If you enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. If you guys need help with anything else, please comment, because I have no idea what you guys want. I tried with the Wii and a ColecoVision, honestly I don't know if you cared about the Casio TV video, but yeah. Hope the Wii one helped though. Honestly, I don't think I have the time to do a homebrew installation for the Wii. Yeah, I guess I'll see you later. Bye.